this is a site called Geoengineering Watch. This is very important. This is, I don't think people realize how important this is. This has been going on a long time, and I've been, I never knew about this site. I've been kind of studying this. I'm an amateur weather person, and I've noticed some weird things with the weather, and I'm not the only one that's noticed. I mean, it's all over the news. That river of moisture going into California. Europe has been getting battered, you know, France, Germany, England, Scandinavia, with storms, 90-mile-an-hour winds, rain. And I see these storms going over South Korea and Japan, and almost right on the border, like they're following the border. And this is not one time. This is over a long time. It's been doing this for at least a few years. I've been watching this stuff. Watch this. This is fascinating. Layers. Just look at the map here. Look at, see, North Korea, South Korea boundary here. Japan, South Korea, Japan. Just look at this. This is fascinating. Radar. Look at this. It's hitting Japan and South Korea, pretty much missing. I've been watching this. The other day it was right on the border. It's pretty much missing. See that, the border? It's almost like it's missing North Korea and China, and it's just hitting South Korea and Japan. The other day it's been doing this. It's been doing this a lot. What is going on? I mean, now here's that storm over South Korea, Japan. It doesn't seem like a start in the ocean here. I've been watching this a long time. These, it's like they start in the ocean and they go up and they don't hit. Just watch where it goes. And they go through, they never go to North Korea, and it goes up Japan. Some weird weather, you know. It's being steered. It's more recently, and there's something strange going on. And I've been talking to some people, and they said to go to this site. And this explains what goes on. Now, this is big news. This is, the evidence is here. This is big. This is as big as the atom bomb, UFOs. I mean, but the evidence is here. It's like the atom bomb. This is real. They are monkeying with our weather. They are monkeying with our weather. They're trying to control the weather. And I believe they are controlling it to an extent, and they may mess things up pretty bad in doing it. This is a good website. It's very good, very well built. You got to see this. I'm really proud that somebody can build something this good, because I see so much junk on the internet, you know. Look at this here. What is geoengineering?
What is geoengineering? Geoengineering means climate engineering and climate mitigation. It means to play God with the weather.
I believe they're attempting it.
The methods of engineering the climate is to fill the atmosphere with light.
These should be disappearing, these contrails. See that? I've seen this. 2 days ago, I watched this. We know that from it was all over.
From around the globe, and patents as well.
They're putting aluminum in the air to stop global warming, and they're putting it in the ocean. 150, did you see that?
Method of solar radiation management.
150 patents for geoengineering. What does that tell you? And Bill Gates is talking about doing this a while back.
Solar radiation management.
Solar radiation management.
The stated purpose to block some of the sun's incoming thermal radiation to try to slow down the greenhouse effect.
Block the sun. I believe they're doing this.
So we have aircraft dispersing light scattering particles.
Look at this.
All over the globe.
These are created by the airplanes.
That's termed global dimming.
And it's getting into the soil, causing problems, the aluminum stuff.
We know that fully 25 to 30% of the sun's direct rays that reached the planet 5 decades ago no longer do. Think about that, 25 to 30%.
72. Now look at this now, how grayish it looks.
These particulates, when they settle down to the sea surface, are then utilized for ocean fertilization, which means to create artificially an algae, a plankton bloom, try to force the ocean to absorb yet more CO2 to take it out of the atmosphere, which causes cataclysmic effects in the ocean. But those behind these programs...
We have had toxin, LJ, the Finger Lakes.
...of what they do. So we have climate engineering to try to block some of the sun's incoming thermal radiation. We have those same materials then settling down to the sea surface, becoming ocean fertilization materials. And all these are causing a catastrophe of downstream consequences that are truly beginning to manifest on our planet.
Look at the jets. I've seen this.
And that's a complex answer to that question. Too many people try to put it in one box.
Why the geoengineering?
Or that answer. It's this and that and many other things.
Stop global warming.
On Senate documents, the stated goal of the U.S. government and multiple agencies in the U.S. government. In these documents, they state their goal of deciding where it rained too much, where it didn't rain enough, as if it's their choice to decide. As you interfere with the climate system, you do damage. And there are many other sources of anthropogenic damage as well. As that damage has mounted and manifested, now you have a great portion of geoengineering is the attempt to hide the damage already done from the population as long as possible, while inflicting yet more damage in the process. We have weather warfare.
Oh yeah, I believe it's going on.
We have the stated goal of not just the U.S. military, but others around the globe to, quote, own the weather for military purposes, owning the weather as a, quote, force multiplier.
There's droughts in places that don't normally have them. And excessive rain in other places. I have no doubt they're causing this. Amazing! They're controlling the weather. This is like wow. I know they did cloud seeding years ago in the '60s to stop hurricanes, and they did it to stop droughts. They dropped stuff into the clouds.
Why would they not want to control the weather when they can win a war without firing a shot? When they can win a war without another country even knowing they went to war. Geoengineering is the pharmaceutical cure for planet Earth. The military-industrial complex keep business as usual as long as possible, hide it from the population.
These are all over. Take a look. Take a look at the sky.
They're not about to let go.
Normal jet set goes out. It doesn't. It disappears.
And people need to not try to put it in one box. But I want to state this. There is no benevolence in these programs.
Can the government legally do it? The government does what it wants. Government does what it wants.
Does the government have a right to conduct these programs over populations? If we move back to a UN treaty in 1976 that was passed, forbidding weather manipulation during wartime, in that treaty, a country's own right to experiment on their own populations was not forbidden.
You really think anybody's going to abide by that during war, especially?
So we have loopholes in the system, especially in regard to national security, where countries are not forbidden to conduct such programs over their own populations. The U.S. military leaders have stated on the record, the greatest and most immediate threat to U.S. national security is the disintegrating climate. Do we really believe that these people in the military-industrial complex are going to ask our permission to intervene with the climate? In the course of our legal proceedings on the climate engineering issue, do our attorneys expect the national security card to be played as this issue begins to come to light? Yes, they do. But is that not an admission that these programs are going on? It is. This is a primary question that so many people use to fortify their denial and walk away from this issue. How many things have they done to themselves already that we already know about? How about detonating over 2,000 nuclear weapons around the globe?
How much cancer they caused. Watch this. This is true. Our own troops they did this to. Our own troops. Look at that. Our own troops.
Which they did not know the consequences of.
Many caught cancer. Thus I say they do these things and they don't care. I mean, I could tell you stories of stuff they did. You scratch your head. Look at all the atom bombs that went off. 2,000 they let off.
Every life form on the planet is contaminated with the fallout from
the ocean, the land, underground, and in space.
After several dozen, but they kept doing it. Let's look at Fukushima. We have now 3 reactors in full meltdown. No end in sight to that situation. No known technology to fix it. And yet, we're building 60 more nuke plants right now. In the case of climate engineering, again, it's a very complex issue. It's not a deliberate attempt necessarily at ecocide, genocide, or omnicide, but it does add up to that. The planet has been irreparably damaged now, and those in power simply look at this as a risk-to-risk scenario, the risk of doing it versus the risk of not doing it. We're already geoengineering the planet. Human activity is a form of geoengineering, period. When you alter the natural life form or life sustaining systems of the planet, you're geoengineering the planet. So from their perspective, they feel compelled to try to engineer the planet to compensate for the damage already done.